So now that we have our basic layout for the dashboard, we need to bring in this chart because we don't have it in ours just yet. So we need to bring that in. Now, this version of AdminLTE, if we take a look at the package.json in the file that we downloaded of AdminLTE, it is actually using version 2.94. So we can just go ahead and bring in that CDN, that 2.94 CDN, and bring it into our project. So if we go to the CDN, I'll put this link in the description. It's cdnjs.com libraries. And then you make sure that you have the correct version, which is 2.94. You can just go ahead and copy this URL, the bundle.js, and then we'll go ahead and bring it into our project. So we'll open up app.blade. Okay, and then we'll just add it under our route, so script, and then just paste it right in there. So this way it'll bring in our chart.js and we can start using it. So we'll go ahead into the dashboard, the admin's dashboard. And right somewhere around the middle, you'll see is where we have the pie chart, the ID, the canvas ID. I'm not going to give you a full layout on how to use it, but essentially it needs a canvas element in order for it to work. So if you look at the documentation, okay, we're going to take a look at this documentation here. And then you go up to the dist file, the dist folder, and then you go the JS folder, the pages folder, and then you go to dashboard2.js. You'll see this is where the jQuery is for that, for the sales chart data, for the chart options. And as I said, this isn't going to be a tutorial on charts, but I'm going to show you that the jQuery, all the stuff that's in there is what we're going to bring into Vue. On our own. Okay, so we'll go back here, go down to dashboard, and we'll head all the way down to where our script tags are. And then I'm going to paste in the methods so that we can see what it is that that code was actually doing. Okay, so this is the first one, which is the sales chart. Let CTX, and then we are grabbing the ID, which was sales chart for the first one. We're getting the context. Again, this is all part of charts. We're giving it a label, we're giving it some colors, we're adding the data to it, some other labels for the other one, January, February, March, sales chart options. This is all, again, within chart JS documentation. So we're just pulling it out and getting it active. The same thing with the pie chart. Okay, so to get these working, again, I'm going to post all of this code up to GitHub, and I'm also going to be posting the links to these pages on where I'm grabbing everything in the description so that you'll have all of that information. Okay, so now we want to come down here and we need a mounted lifecycle hook so that now when the page mounts, it'll mount these charts. Okay, so it'll be there, comma, and then it'll be this.saleschart because that's the function that we have here. So this.sales chart, and the next one is this.py chart. Okay, we'll let that compile, and then we'll go back to the browser. We'll go back to our page, and now we should see our chart right in here. So refresh. Okay, now you can see we have our sales chart, and we also have the pie chart down here. If we go ahead and open up the Inspect Tools, we're going to see that there are a bunch of errors. And some of the errors that we get are coming from Chrome themselves, or Google Chrome themselves. Okay, for instance, this one, which is saying that the ESM bundler build a view, it is recommended to configure your bundler. Okay, if you click this link, it explains to you what the problem is. And this is a Vue.js 3 problem. Okay, it has something to do with the Vue Next package. Okay, and it tells you, see if we can find it, it tells you how to handle these, and that's to bring it into the webmix. Okay, so if we go back to our text editor, and then we go all the way down to webpack config, okay, we need to make some changes in here. So the first thing we can do is add var webpack and it's just creating a variable, and we'll say require webpack. Okay, and let's move this down, give it a little room. And then under this resolve here, we'll say plugins, open that up, and we'll call new webpack dot define plugin __, and then it's going to be view _ options, and make sure this is in caps, API _, and we'll say true. And the next one is going to be __ view. Oh, these need to be in caps. View _ prod for production _ dev tools __. And this needs to be another _ as well. Make sure it's two. Okay, then we say semicolon false. Okay, so let's go ahead. We'll make this recompile. npm run watch. Okay, now that that's done, we can head back to the browser. And now this, hopefully this error will now be gone. So we'll go ahead. We'll also clear the cache when we do this. Empty cache and hard reload. Okay, and let's check. And now we don't have that particular error anymore. Okay, now this moment.min.js map, this just came with the installation that we did. So we can go ahead and take that out of here to get rid of that error, because we're not even using moment.js. So we'll go ahead, cut that out. And now we shouldn't have that error anymore. So go back, refresh. Okay, and now we don't have that error anymore, as you can see. Now here, at sidebar, looks like I misspelled one of the inertia links. So we'll go back, we'll go to the sidebar component, and we'll just do a quick search for inertia. And there it is. We'll add our case. Okay, and now that should be good. So let's go back, refresh. Okay, now those errors are gone, and this is just my own personal thing that's there. You probably won't have this, but we can also get rid of the popper.js one. So we'll go back to our text editor, and then you want to make sure that you stop your npm, okay? You're going to want to go to webpack.mix, and now where I have disabled notifications here, you want to add dot source maps, and that should get rid of that last error that we have. So let's make sure and recompile this. We can just run npm run dev for this one. Once that's finished, we can head back to the browser and try it again. So now we should be getting rid of this source map popper.js one. So go back, refresh. Okay, and as you can see, now it's gone, and the only one that I have is the one from my personal Chrome extension, which is throwing up an error. But if you don't have this, then all of those errors on the right should be gone, and you should be good to go. Okay, I'm going to leave it here. I'm going to make sure to post in the description all of the links that we used for today. I'm not going to put this one up because I showed you, if you have that error, to click it, but this will explain to you about that view options and ESM bundler error, and you can also Google it to read more up about what's going on with that. But I'm going to leave it here. I'm going to put all those links in the description. I'm going to push all the code up to GitHub. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you guys next time.